Good morning, everyone. So in the previous class, we are discussing about the hydrological channel routing. Okay, and in that hydrological channel routing, we are discussing about Muskingum method of routing. So we have stopped in the requirement and procedure. What are the values required for Muskingum method of routing and how to proceed with this method? We have discussed in the previous class. Okay, so today we are going to solve some numerical. So basically, this is your last topic of your syllabus. But one topic is also left, that is your depth area calculation of the precipitation chapter. Okay, so I will give you notes also for that depth area calculation. And the thing is that we will be required in some one or two classes more. Anyway, so what are the requirements for Muskingum method of routing? So to use the Muskingum method of equation to route, what are the values required? Obviously, you will have the inflow values, okay, through a reach. So what is a reach? I have already told you, suppose you have a channel, okay, suppose you have a channel, and suppose you have two sections, you have taken two sections along the channel, or the area, okay, or the area in between these two sections is called as what? It is called as reach, R-E-A-C-H. Okay, so what do you mean by reach? Suppose you have suppose this is your channel, you have taken one section in here. Suppose this is your x dash, and suppose this is your another section y dash. Okay, so in between these two sections we call it as reach. Okay, so for this reach, what values you should have? You should have the value of your inflow value you should have. Then obviously you should have the value of your knx. Why knx is required? To find out the values of your c0, c1 and c2. And for that I have also showed you one trick. How to, if you do not remember how to get the value of your c0, c1 and c2, then you should use one trick to get the formula. Okay, so formula you already know, that is your c0 is equal to k minus in the denominator it is a k minus kx plus 0.5 into t, and at the numerator it was minus kx plus 0.5 into delta t. Okay, for c1 that is equal to kx plus 0.5 t divided by k minus kx plus 0.5 into delta t, and for C2 the value is k minus kx minus 0.5 delta t divided by k minus kx plus 0.5 delta t. So I think all of you have got the PDF I have given in the classroom. Anyway, so what is the requirement? So requirement is you should have the value of inflow of the reach, then the values of your k and x for the reach, and the value of outflow q1 and the Q1 from the reach. Okay, so obviously you should have one value of your Q1, that is one discharge value you should have to route this with respect to what? With respect to our hydrological channel routing, that is we are studying here is Muskingum method of routing. Okay, so procedure, first you have to know the value of your knx, and after that you have to select an appropriate value of delta t. Okay, then after that you have to find out the value of your c0, C1 and C2, and already you know that your C0 plus C1 plus C2 is equal to how much? Anybody remembers? What is the value of C0 plus C1 plus C2? If you add C0, C1 and C2, then what is the value? In the previous class also, one. So calculate C1 and C2. Suppose though you have the formula of 3, for these three terms, for C0 you have one equation, then for C1 you have one equation, and C2 you have one equation, but you don't have to use the formula every time. Suppose you have determined the value of C0 and C1, C0, okay, then you can use the formula that C0 plus C1 plus C2 is equal to 1. Okay, so you don't have to use the formula for C2. Okay, if you have find out C0 and C1, simply just add the C0 and C1, then from 1 minus the value, then you will get the value of your C2. Okay, that way also you can find it out. If you know the value of 2, C0, suppose C1 and C2 you know, then obviously you can calculate the value of your C0. Then after that, starting from the initial conditions, that is what I1 and Q1, it is you should have the value of I1 and Q1, and the known I2. Okay, known I2 at the end of the first time step delta t, what you'll have to do, you have to calculate the Q2 by equation. Which equation? By equation in which equation? If you remember, that is Q2 is equal to C0 plus I2. Do you remember this? Q2 is equal to C0 plus I2 plus C1 plus I1 plus C2 into Q, C2 into Q1. Okay, that is formula is Q2 is equal to C0 plus I2 plus C1 into I1 plus C2 into Q1. Okay, so this formula you have already got in the previous class. So from this equation you have to find the value of your Q2. So after calculating the Q2, this Q2 for the second step, okay, for the second step means for the next routing with respect to your Muskingum method of routing, this Q2 will be your, for the second case it will be your value of your Q1. Okay, so like this you have to calculate. যেটো তুমি কিউ টু কেলকুলেট কৰি উলিয়াবা ফাৰ্ষ্ট ষ্টেপত, সেইটো ছেকেণ্ড ষ্টেপৰ কি হ'ব, কিউ ওৱান হ'ব, ঠিক আছে? চ' লাইক দিছ ইউ হেভ টু কেলকুলেট। চ' ইফ ইউ কম্পেয়াৰ দি মডিফাইড মুলছ মেথড এণ্ড দি মাস্কিংহাম চেনেল অফ মাস্কিংহাম মেথড অফ ৰাউটিং, দেন ইউ উইল বি এবল টু চি ডেট দিছ মেথড ইজ ভেৰি মাছ ইজি কম্পেয়াৰ টু ডেট অফ দি মডিফাইড মুলছ মেথড। অ'কে, ইন মডিফাইড মুলছ মেথড উই হেভ টু ডু লটছ অফ আইটাৰেশ্যনছ, দেন অবভিয়াছলি ইউ হেভ টু ড্ৰ চাম গ্ৰাফছ ৰিলেটেড টু দিছ, এণ্ড there is lots of possibility that when you are going to do it by manually, then lots of possibility that the calculation, there may be mistakes in the calculation. Okay, but here it is a simple method. So for that I will solve one numerical. Okay, so the thing is that in your book a numerical based on your Muskingum method is already given, so I have taken numerical from the exercise. Okay, so this is your exercise, that is problem 8.6 from the K. Subramanian. It is not done in your book, so I have calculated it, so you just go through it. Okay, so a detention reservoir was found to have a linear storage, so see here, here it is written as linear storage discharge relationship S is equal to KU. So S is equal to KU means it is what it is given. So you already have got two type of storages, one is your prism storage and another one is your, if you remember, I have already told you in the previous class, one is like tapered step and this tapered step of storage is known as what? দেখাইছিলো যে সেকশনটো লোৱাৰ পিছত তুমি কেনেকৈ পাইছিলা, দিছ ইজ ইয়ৰ প্ৰিজম ষ্টৰেজ, ওৱান ইজ ইয়ৰ লাইক দিছ, বিকজ ইউ অলৰেডি ন' ডেট ইন কেছ অফ চেনেল ডিপ দি ষ্টৰেজ অফ ৱাটাৰ ইজ নট পেৰেলেল, চ' ডিপ ৰিজাৰ্ভাৰ হ'লে কি হ'ব, ৰিজাৰ্ভাৰ ইন ৰিজাৰ্ভাৰ ইয়ৰ অভিয়াছলি ইয়ৰ ষ্টৰেজ উইল বি ৱাট, ইট উইল বি ভাৰ্টিকেল, বাট ইন কেছ অফ চেনেল ইট ডাজণ্ট মিনছ ডিপ storage is parallel to what, parallel to the bed in case of your reservoir, but in case of channel it doesn't happen like this. Okay, when the inflow is high, then what will happen, it will give you a peak flow. Okay, and after that when the inflow will be less or when the inflow stops, then what will happen, so like the graph of your flood runoff hydrograph. Okay, so you can consider this base flow as the reservoir, and this flow is, you can consider this rising limb and the falling limb, you can consider for that portion, that is your this storage. Okay, what is this storage, so this portion you already know, that is your prism storage. So what was it, anyone, if you even remember, I have already told you in the previous class, this is your waste, monod ase waste storage. Okay, w e t z e, waste storage. So here it is given as so for waste storage your equation was one. What was the equation for waste storage? Pure report depend kore boli koisilo waste storage. So in case of your channel routing, for prism routing, for prism storage, suppose this is your prism storage and this is your waste storage. So for prism storage, your discharge storage depends on what? ফৰ্মুলাটো দেখাইছিলো যে এছ ইজ প্ৰপৰচনেল টু কিউ, অ'কে, দিছ ইজ ফৰ প্ৰিজম ষ্ট'ৰেজ, prism. And for wave storage, what was it? Obviously, for wave storage, you should have the value of what? Your inflow should be always greater than your outflow. So, means it depends on what? I minus Q. Then only you will get this graph rise in the peak value. So that is why your, in case of your wave storage, it depends on what? It depends on waste storage. It depends on inflow and outflow. Okay, that is the difference between inflow and outflow will give you the waste storage. And for this prism storage, it depends on the only what? Discharge. Okay, so now here it is given as your storage depends on what? Storage depends on S is equal to KU. So it is obviously you have the prism storage. Okay, there is no waste storage is in here because it is not dependent on the inflow and outflow. And that is why here it is written as, so that this where it is have a linear storage. See here, here it is a linear storage. Okay, as it is, they are considering it is a linear. This waste portion they are not considering. So that is why it is going through the relationship S is equal to KU. Okay, so for this storage, you have to show that the storage routing equation of an inflow hydrograph through a reservoir is Q2 is equal to C1 I1 bar plus C2 Q2. Okay, so for this storage, that is for this prism storage, you have to evaluate an equation, that is Q2 is equal to C1 I1 bar is it plus C2 into Q2. So this I1 bar, okay, this I1 bar, how to calculate it? I have already told you that is your I1 plus I2 divided by 2. It will give you I bar. Okay, so like this you have to find it out where C1 and C2 are the constants and I1 bar is equal to I1 plus I2 divided by 2. Okay, so now determine the values of C1 and C2 in terms of K and the routing time step delta t. Okay, so for delta t, for the routing time delta t and the for in terms of K, you should have to calculate the value of your C1 and C2. Here your C1 and C2 value you have to calculate. Okay, and now if K is equal to 4 hour and delta t is equal to 2 hour, delta t is equal to 2 hour, route the following inflow hydrograph through this reservoir. Assume initial condition that T is equal to 0, I is equal to here 0. Okay, and Q1 is equal to 0. So for initial condition, your inflow is equal to 0, I1 is equal to 0, and Q1 is equal to 0. That is, the outflow is also is equal to 0. So for that, you have to route this. Okay, the value is given in here. So the problem is 8.6, problem number 8.6 from your book. So here in this equation, so first write it down. Step by steps, you just go through it. Okay, so your storage is equal to what? It depends on what? Proportional to your outflow. Okay, outflow growth depends on storage, depends on outflow. So obviously, when you are going to remove the proportional sign, then obviously you have to give one K. Okay, K means that is your what? That is your constant. Okay.
Sir.
What?
Sir, which portion of triangular when?
Triangular or tapered position, it will be agar PDF to solid to me on agar PDF to my data issue. Thank you very much. So this is your channel, the ZS channel took to me do the section of Bhakurilosa. So here with Ramazor area took to me Kibuligua, Reeds Buligua, Tarasa to me the A posted with the data to me Sidropasa to be Kanakiba. Current Eta portion to my key has Porlu TSA, or Eta portion key has A to my reservoir level to us. So Tarpram to me Kigombala, Upor portion to Zitu Kosu, Zitu to my linear noy. Take a say, Mane A to portion to be Kanaka, the D to me two dimensionally, so what it can get over posted. এনেকে আছে হ্যাঁ আৰু তাৰ পাছত আমি এ পৰচনটো লৈছো এ সেকচনটো দিস সেকচন আই হ্যাভ টেকেন ওকে সো এটো তোমাৰ হৈল বেছ টু আছে তো এখিনি হৈ গল কি প্ৰিজম ষ্টৰেজ হৈ গল আৰু এ পৰচনটো কি হৈ গল তোমাৰ ওয়েষ্ট ষ্টৰেজ হৈ গল লাইক দিস ओके ए पोर्शन तो तुम जदि सुआ टू एटु तो थ्री डायमेंशनल टाइप ऑफ वस्तु तो होय आसे ठीक आसे आरो एटु की होय आसे तो आइसोमेट्रिक व्यू आरो एटु तुम्हार की फेटु व्यू होय आसे तो ऑर्थोग्राफिक व्यू जदि तुम सुआ तेतिया एटु केनेके देखिबा एनेके देखिबा ए पोर्शन तो तुम जदि तुम ए फलो पर सुआ इयार पर टू डायमेंशनली বুঝি পাইছা মানে এই পোরশনটো তোমাৰ কি হৈ গ'ল ইয়াৰ পৰা ইয়ালে পোরশনটো প্রিজম স্টোরেজ আৰু এই ওপৰ পোরশনটো কি হৈ গ'ল ওয়ে স্টোরেজ ঠিক আছে
সো ওয়াটার লেটটো ওপেনিং হ'লে প্যারালাল হ'ব
কোনটো
মানে ওয়াটার লেটটো
তোমাৰ প্রিজম স্টোরেজৰ লগত আমি ধৰি লওঁ যে বেডৰ লগত প্যারালালি তোমাৰ মানে কি হয় যেটো মানে স্টোরেজ হয় হেতু Parallelly হয় বুলি ধৰে কিন্তু ইয়াৰ লগত তেনেকুৱা একো কথা নাই। Parallelly বা perpendicular ইয়াত channel লগত কথা নাই কাৰণ ইয়াত তোমাৰ কি হৈ আছে inflow আৰু outflow ওপৰত depend কৰি আছে যিমানে তোমাৰ inflow বেছি হ'ব outflow টো তোমাৰ সদায় কি হ'ব এটা তো rate হে পঠাব পাৰিব sink কেদি বা তোমাৰ যিটো outlet থাকিব তো তাত যদি তোমাৰ inflow যিমানে বেছি হ'ব কিমানে তোমাৰ কি হ'ব peak টো বেছি হ'ব ন because it always depends on inflow minus outflow for prism routing বুজি পাইছা ইলিভেশন রিলেটেড সাপোজ তোমার ইয়ালেকে প্রিজমত ইয়ালেকে ইমানলেকে ওয়াটার লেভেল আছে সাপোজ তোমার ইনফ্লো যেটা আহিলে আৰু আহিলে কেনেকে বাহিব স্টোরেজ তো কেনেকে বাহিব বলি কৈছে এনেকে যাব ওপৰলে এনেকে যাব স্টোরেজ তো এটা টাইমত মানে হেকাৰণে কি কৈ প্যারালালি মানে বাহি গৈ থাকিব মানে বেডৰ লগত ইয়াত অলপ বেছি হ'ব ইয়াত কম হ'ব তেনেকে নহয় মানে স্টোরেজ ঠিক আছে স্টোরেজ তুমি রিজার্ভার দেখিলে দেখিবা যে তার লেভেল তো ওয়াটার লেভেল তো একেই থাকে ন প্রায় সমান থাকে কিন্তু চ্যানেলত কি হৈছে চ্যানেল মানে রিভারত কি হৈছে রিভারত তো তোমার বই ওয়াটার তো গৈ আছে দেখিছা ন রিভারত তাত ওয়েভ নেচার আছে ওয়েভ তো কনসিডার কৰি লিখিবা যে তাত কি কেনেকে থাকে রিভারর ওয়েভ বিলাক যদি পারত থাকিব তুমি ওয়েভ পুরস তে কেনেকে দেখিবা ওয়েভ নেচার ন ওয়েভ নেচার অফ ওয়াটার থাকে তো এনেকে মানে কি এটা জায়গা মানে তাতে তুমি যদি সেই ওয়েভ তোতে তুমি যদি সেকশন তো লৈ লবা তো এটা পোরশন তুমি কি দেখিলা মিনি লো মানে ইয়াতে তোমার কি হবো এটো তোমার বেস ফ্লো বুলি ধরে লোলা যে যা তুমি শেষ হয়েছে ওয়েভ তো ঠিক আছে তারপর তুমি যেখানে পিক তো পালা এইখানে পোর্শন তুমি রাইজিং লিম বলে ধরে লোলা হাইড্রোগ্রাফত যে করেছিল আর এই ফলিং লিম ওয়েভ ওয়েভ নেচারের কারণে যেটু হয় চ্যানেল বা তুমি যেটা আমার সাইড যা আছে তোমার ক্যানেল চ্যানেল বিলাক ওয়াটার সোটার গিয়ে থাকে সেগুলো ওয়েভ নেচারত গিয়ে থাকে সাবা কিন্তু রিজার্ভারত সেই ওয়েভ নেচার তুমি দেখা নোপা ন ঠিক আছে বস্তুটো বুঝি পাইছা নাই ইয়াতে কি কৰিছো ইয়াতে ক্রস সেকশনটো লৈ লৈছো ক্রস সেকশনটো লৈ পেলাই এইটো ড্র কৰিলো ফার্স্টতে আৰু এই ড্র কৰাটোকে আকৌ অর্থোগ্রাফিক যেতিয়া আমি ভিউত চাইছো এই বস্তুটো যেতিয়া আমি এফালৰ পৰা চাইছো তেতিয়া আমি কেনেকে দেখিম এই পোরশনটো এই পোরশনটো এই পোরশনটো ইয়া লাগে আৰু এই ওপৰৰ পোরশনখিনি এটো মানে যদি আমি এখানে কাটি দিওঁ ধৰি লোৱা এটো কাটি দিলো এই পোরশনখিনি এটো পোরশন ঠিক আছে বুঝি পালা So now according to the question it is given as storage is equal to KQ okay so storage K S is equal to KQ so storage also you know that this change in storage you can write it down as S2 minus S1 is equal to K into Q2 minus Q1 so this formula you already know okay so now according to the basic equation what was the formula S2 minus S1 is equal to I1 plus I2 divided by 2 into delta T minus q1 plus q2 divided by 2 into delta t so this is your continuity equation you already know this so now you have one this equation one equation and this is your second equation so when you are going to combine this that is your combining 1 and 2 what you are going to get you will get k into q2 minus q1 is equal to this okay so s1 yatu so yate s2 minus s1 and here also s2 minus s1 so I have combined 1 and 2 and I have got the equation k into q2 minus q1 is equal to I1 plus I2 divided by 2 this one into delta t minus Q1 plus Q2 divided by 2 into delta t okay so K into Q1 minus Q2 so simply what you have to do this I1 plus I2 divided by 2 into delta t according to the equation it is equal to how much it is equal to I1 bar okay so simply write it down I bar not I1 bar this is I bar okay this portion this portion is your IVAR. So simply I have write it down as IVAR. This is given in the question, or you already know that how to calculate the IVAR, that is your I1 plus I2 divided by 2. And this delta D, same keep it like this. Then just expand this portion. Okay, so Q1 by 2 into delta D, Q1 is minus, then Q1 into delta D divided by 2. Okay, then minus, this minus, then Q2 into delta D divided by 2. Okay, so after that, expand this portion. So KQ2 and the Q2 term, okay, that is the Q2 term. This Q2 term, just I have bring it to the left side. Okay, so KQ2 plus Q2 into delta D, this portion I have bring it to that side. And the KQ1, I bring it to that portion. Okay, so after that, simplify it. So Q2, after simplifying it, what I can do? I can take the common, that is Q2, I can take common. So Q2 I have taken, then you will have the K plus delta T divided by 2 is equal to I into delta T minus Q1 into delta T by 2 plus K into Q1. Okay, so after that, obviously you have to find out the equation of what? Find out the equation of Q2 is equal to, like this formula you have to find out to get the value of your C1 and C2. So simply find out the value of your Q2. Okay, so Q2 will be IVAR, that is your IVAR. So this portion will go to that portion. So delta T, okay, delta T divided by K plus delta T divided by 2, that portion. Now I have bring it to here, plus Q1 I have taken common. Okay, then this K minus this Q1 I have taken common. Okay, so after taken common, what I am going to get? I am going to get K minus Q1 divided by Q1 is common, so delta T divided by 2. This portion will be there, and this K plus delta T divided by 2 will be in here. So ultimately you will get the formula, this formula you have got. So if you see that these equations resembles to what? Q2 is equal to, that is given in the question. Okay, Q2 is equal to C1 I1 bar C1. Okay, this is C1 I bar, not I1 bar, plus C2 into Q1, resembles to that equation. According to the basic equation, the basic equation is given as is equal to how much? It is equal to Q2 is equal to C1 I1 bar plus C2 Q2. This is not I1, I bar. Okay, so now after comparing this 3 and equation 4, you will get what? This I bar is equal to same. So C1 you can write it down as delta T divided by K plus delta T by 2, and C2, this C2 into Q1. So C2 you can write it down as K minus delta T divided by 2 divided by K plus delta T divided by 2. Okay, so you have find out the value of your C1 and C2. So your first portion is completed. Okay, so after that you have to route this for K is equal to 4 hours and delta T is equal to 2 hours. Okay, so now this if K is equal to 4 hours and delta T is equal to 2 hours, now find out the value of your C1 and C2. C1 or C2 value to market, calculate correlation. So you have already determined the formula for that equation. C1 and C2 value formula for that equation. So the formula is a delta T. So in this case, your delta T is equal to 2 hours. Simply put 2. Then K is equal to how much? 4 plus 2 divided by 2 is equal to, you will get is 0.4. Okay, for C1 value you will get 0.4, and for C2 you will get the value of your K minus delta T divided by 2 divided by K plus delta T divided by 2, you will get 0.6. okay, so now whether it is correct or not, you can simply calculate it, because you already know C0 plus C1 plus C2 is equal to 1. Okay, so 0.4 plus 0.6 is equal to 1, because your C0 value is not given here. So now you can say that these values is correct, okay, because it is following the equation. Now after that, how to calculate the Q2? Q2 kind of formula is there. What is the formula for Q2? Q2 is equal to C0 plus. What was the formula? Anyone? C0 or logot kya sile? Multiply kya ho? I1 or I2? I 2, then C1 or logot kya sile? I1, okay, plus C2 into Q2, sorry, Q1. Understand it? Equation. So now your inflow is given. These values are given, time is given, and inflow is given. Okay, after that, you have to find the value of your IVAR. So how to find the value of your IVAR? Simply add this. So for the first value, I1 plus I2, so your I1 value is not available here. So 0, simply put it in like this, or you can simply put it as 0, okay? Like this, 0. Then for the second case, your value is how much? Your value is 10, so 0, it is 20. So 0 plus 20 divided by 2 is equal to how much? 10. Then 20 plus 60 is equal to 80 divided by 2 is equal to how much? It is equal to 40. So that is your IVAR value, because you already know IVAR is equal to I1 plus I2 divided by 2. Okay. So now again, you have to find out the value of your this 60 plus 100 divided by 2. It will give you 80, like this. Okay. 60 plus 40 divided by 2, it will give you 50. So like this, you have to find the for every value, you have to find the value of your IVAR. Okay, so now you have the value of your C1. This C0, this term, you don't have the value, because C1, it is not given. So obviously, you should have to know the value of this. Okay, C1 plus I1 plus C2 into Q1. Okay, so C2 into Q1 and C1 IVAR. So how to calculate the C1 IVAR? Simply, the formula is C1 IVAR. So IVAR you have already calculated, that is equal to 10, and C1 you have calculated is equal to 0.4. so 0.4 into 10 is equal to 4, then 0.4 into 40 is equal to 16. Okay, 80 into 0.4, it will give you 32. 90 into 0.4, it will give you 36. 70 into 0.4, it will give you 28, like this. Okay, then 25 into 0.4, it will give you 10. Then 15 into 0.4, it will give you 6. Like this, you have to find out the value of C1 I1 bar. Okay, then after that, you have to find the value of C2 into Q1. You can also do it without drawing this table, or without doing without the help of this table also, table. Okay, but it is recommended to do it using the table, then only your problem will be systematic, and it will take small space. Okay, less space. So your C2 into Q1 is equal to 0.6. You already know C2 Q1, you have to find it out. So C2 Q1 is equal to 0.6 into Q1. Why I am putting 0.6? Because C2 value is equal to 0.6. I have already calculated from the previous formula obtained. Okay. So now, here you have to put the value, that is your C2 Q1. So Q1 value is equal to how much? So now after that, what first after getting the value of your Q1 value, it is given as is equal to how much? For the first case, according to the equation, your Q1 is equal to how much? It is equal to 0. Clear? For the first, assume initial condition that T is equal to 0, I1 is equal to 0, and Q1 is equal to 0. So now for the first case, your Q, this case, okay? So here you will not have any value of Q1. So now, this value, okay? So here you are, obviously you are going to get the value of how much? You are going to get the value of 0, because Q1 is equal to given as is equal to how much? Q1 is equal to, it is equal to 0. So ultimately this term will be 0, and obviously this is also 0 for the first time, that is IVAR is equal to 0. So this term is also equal to 0. So total discharge at the first step at 0 hours will be how much? 0 plus 0, it will give you 0. So this 0, this Q2 0 for the first case, now already I have told you, this will act as a Q1 for the second case. Q1, so Q1 or value kiman hobo diya yare. Q1 value will be 0 in this case. For the second case, your Q1 value will be the Q2 value of the previous case. So 0, simply put 0, C2 into 0 is equal to 0.6 into 0, is it will give you 0. Okay, so now C1 IVAR, that is 4 and 0, it will give you 4. Now this 4 will act as a what? Q1 value for that third case. Okay, so now 4 into 0.6 is equal to 2.4. So and 16 plus 2.4, it will give you 18.4. Then this 18.4, that is the value of your Q2 for the third step, will act as a Q1 value for the fourth case. Okay, 18.4 into 0.6 is equal to 11.04. So 32 plus 11.04, it will give you 43.04. Like this, you have to calculate for all of them. Okay, now what will be the, how to get this 25.82? 43.04 into 0.6, it will give you this value. Okay, so like this, you have to calculate, and after that you have to add this, it will give you the discharge. So you should have to calculate actually for all the you have to do these iterations, or you can say you have to do perform this thing until you get the Q2 value of 0 or approximately near to 0. Okay, here I have got 4.29, but you, if you want, you can also perform this until you get the value of 0. If you do it for 2 or 3 steps, you will get the value of 0. Okay, so like this you can do. ফার্স্ট কেসটো কিউ টুৰ ভেলু কিমান আছিলে জিৰ আছিলে একৰ্ডিং টু দি কুৱেশ্যন দিয়া আছে ইয়াতে কিউ টুৰ ভেলুটো জিৰ দিয়া আছে সৰি কিউ ওৱানৰ ভেলু জিৰ দিয়া আছে কিউ ওৱানৰ ভেলুটো তুমি ফাৰ্ষ্টতে ইয়াতে জিৰ পুট কৰা জিৰ পুট কৰিলে চি টু কিউ ওৱানৰ ভেলুটো কি হৈ গ'ল জিৰ হৈ গ'ল আৰু ইকুৱেশ্যনটো তুমি গম পোৱা চি নট প্লাছ আই টু প্লাছ চি ওৱান আই ওৱান আই বাৰ প্লাছ চি টু কিউ কিউ ওৱান চ' চি টু কিউ ওৱান তুমি উলিয়ালা আৰু তুমি চি ওৱান আই বাৰ উলিয়ালা দিছ টাৰ্ম তুমি উলিয়ালা চ' এড কৰি তুমি কি পাবা কিউ টু পাবা বিকজ আমাৰ ওচৰত চি নট নাইয়ে ভেলু তেতিয়া তুমি কি কৰিলা এই দুটা এড কৰি দিলা তুমি কি পাই গলা কিউ টু পাই গলা কিউ টুৰ ভেলু জিৰ' পাই গলা ত' ছেকেণ্ড ষ্টেপত তুমি যদি প্ৰচিডিউৰটো চোৱা কেনেকে কৰিব লাগে ত' প্ৰচিডিউৰ ইজ এই কিউ টু যিটো তুমি ফাৰ্ষ্ট ষ্টেপত পালা সেইটো তোমাৰ ছেকেণ্ড ষ্টেপৰ কাৰণে কি হ'ব কিউ ওৱান হ'ব এইটো ষ্টেপৰ কাৰণে তোমাৰ কিউ ওৱান হ'ব বুজি পাইছা নাই ত' এতিয়া ইয়াত যেতিয়া জিৰ' হৈ গ'ল কিউ ওৱানটো জিৰ' হৈ গ'ল এতিয়া তুমি জিৰ' পুট কৰি দিয়া চি টু কিউ ওৱানটো কিমান পাই গলা জিৰ' পাই গলা কিন্তু ইয়াত চি ওৱান আই ওৱানৰ ভেলু তুমি ফ'ৰ পাই দিছিলা ত' ফ'ৰ প্লাছ জিৰ' কৰি দিয়া একৰ্ডিং টু দিছ ইকুৱেশ্যন ফ'ৰ প্লাছ জিৰ' ইজ ইকুৱেল টু ফ'ৰ পাই গলা নাও যেতিয়া তুমি ছেকেণ্ড ষ্টেপত এইটো তোমাৰ কিউ টু ভেলু হৈ গ'ল এই কিউ টু ভেলুটো ইয়াৰ কাৰণে এই ফ'ৰটো তোমাৰ কিমান কি হয় কি ভেলু হৈ গ'ল কিউ ওৱানৰ ভেলু হৈ গ'ল ত' ফ'ৰ ইন্টু জিৰ' পইণ্ট ছিক্স ইট উইল গিভ ইউ টু পইণ্ট ফ'ৰ ছিক্সটিন প্লাছ টু পইণ্ট ফ'ৰ ইট উইল গিভ ইউ এইটিন পইণ্ট ফ'ৰ চ' লাইক দিছ ইউ হেভ টু পাৰফৰ্ম অ'কে হেৰি মেথডতো আমি যেতিয়া কৰিছিলো মডিফাইড মুল মেথড আই ওৱান প্লাছ আই টু ডিভাইড বাই টু কৰি পেলাই কৰো ন আই টু ইউজ কৰো ইয়াতো তেনেকে আই টু তেনেকে ইউজ কৰিছো আচলতে ইয়াৰ যিটো আই যে আমি যে কেলকুলেট কৰো যে আই ওৱানটো যে কেলকুলেট কৰো এই আই ওৱান টুটো আমি কি কৰো আচলতে আই ওৱান প্লাছ মানে এইটো স্মল আই ওৱান প্লাছ আই টু ডিভাইড বাই টু কৰিয়েতো আমি এইটো কৰো ইকুৱেশ্যনটো চাবা তুমি লাষ্ট ক্লাছত যে আমি ইভালুৱেট কৰি যে উলিয়াইছিলো যে এছ টু মাইনাছ এছ ওৱানৰ ফৰ্মুলাটো কেনেকে উলিয়াইছিলা এছ টু মাইনাছ এছ ওৱান ইজিকুৱেল টু আই ওৱান প্লাছ আই টু ডিভাইড বাই টু আৰু সেই আই ওৱান প্লাছ আই টু ডিভাইড বাই টু টুৱেটো পিছত কম্বাইন হৈ পেলাই ফৰ্মুলাটো যিটো দিছিলে চি নট প্লাছ আই টু প্লাছ চি ওৱান ইন্টু আই ওৱান প্লাছ চি টু প্লাছ কিউ ওৱান আৰু আই ওৱানৰ ভেলুটো কি আছিলে স্মল আই ওৱান প্লাছ আই টু মানে এইকেইটা ভেলু ঠিক আছে এনেকে ইয়াত দুটা দুটা ভেলু এড কৰি তুমি আই ওৱানৰ পাবা একে মই ইয়াতে আই ওৱান বাৰ দিছো আৰু ইয়াতে দিয়ে থোৱা আছে আই বাৰ ইজিকুৱেল টু আই ওৱান প্লাছ আই টু ডিভাইড বাই টু So like this you can calculate, okay, outflow. Now for the second problem, the storage in the reach has been studied, okay. The storage in the reach has been studied. The values of x and k in the masking time equation has been identified as 0.28 and 1.6 days. If the inflow hydrograph to the reach is given below, compute the outflow hydrograph. Assume the outflow from the reach at t is equal to 0 is 35 meter cube per second. Outflow from the reach at t is equal to 0. At t is equal to 0, your outflow is equal to how much? 35 meter cube per second. That is your Q2 value for the first step is given. So before doing that, obviously for determination of the Q2 value for every step, this value is given. Okay, that is the value 35 for inflow. That is 35. Then it is how much? It is 55, 92 at 12 hours. It is 130, 160. That is inflow. Okay, 140. These values are given and also your outflow from the reach at the t is equal to 0 before the starting of the flood it is given as is equal to how much 35 meter cube per second now your c dot value so you already know the formula c dot is equal to minus kx plus 0.5 into delta t divided by k minus kx plus 0.5 into delta t so what is the value of your k what is the value of your k that is given as is equal to 1.6 days So obviously you have to convert it into hours. So 1.6 days is equal to how many hours? 38.4 hours, 1.6 into 24. Okay, so it will give you 38.4. 1.6 days into 24 hours, that will give you 38.4. Clear? So 38.4 into 0.28, that is the x value, that is equal to 0.28. Okay, plus 0.5 into 6. See, what is the 6? That is the delta t. Okay, so here delta t is in hours, so that is why I have converting this k into what? Into these days into hours. Okay, so the hours of the other convert proof on the 24. So minus 38.4 into 0.28 plus 0.5 into 6, and k, that is equal to 38.4 minus 38.4 into 0.28 plus 0.5 into 6. Okay, it will give you the value of your c naught is equal to how much? Minus 0.253. Then c1 will be equal to how much? So you already know the formula, kx plus 0.5 into delta t divided by k minus kx plus 0.5 into delta t. Okay, is equal to, sorry, here one is your k minus, okay, k minus kx minus 0.5 into delta t. So your formula will be 38.4 into 0.28 plus 0.5 into 6 divided by 38.4 minus 38.4 into 0.28 plus 0.5 into 6. It will give you the value of 0.449. So now you have calculated the value of your c naught and c1. Okay, so now how to calculate the c2 value? You can simply put it in this equation. In this equation, you can put, or the formula you already know, that is equal to how much? That is c0 plus c1 plus c2 is equal to 1. c0 plus c1 plus c2 is equal to 1. So simply from this equation, just calculate the value of your c2. So put the value of your c0, that is equal to minus 0.253, and c1 value is equal to how much? 0.449. And so from this, you find out the value of your c2. I have got it as 0.804. You can check by this equation also. Okay. Anyway, so now you already know how to find out the value of your Q2. Q2 is equal to C0 plus I2 plus C1 plus I1 plus C2 into Q1. Okay, so now I is equal to how much? What is the value of I given according to the equation? This is the given in the equation up to this marked with red color. That is for 0 hours, it is equal to 35. For 6 hours, at 6 hours, at time interval of 6 hours, it is how much? 55. At 12 hours, it is 92 meter cube per second. Then at 18 hours, it is 130 meter cube per second. 24 hours, it is 160 meter cube per second. At 30 hours, it is 140 meter cube per second. Okay. So now, how to find out the value of this term, and this term. Okay. So C0 value you have already calculated. C0 into I2. So I2 value. So I2 value will be how much? 35. So this for this value, you do have no value of your I1. So simply you will have to calculate from this. But for this first step, at the time zero, your outflow is given as is equal to how much? Before the starting of the flood, it is given as 35 meter cube per second according to the equation. If you remember, this is the value already given. Okay, so this 35 value will be work as a what? It will work as a Q1 value for the second step. So calculator, if you want to do, take out your calculator and find out accordingly. Okay, so your C0 is equal to how much? Minus 0.253. So minus 0.253 into I2. Okay, so I2 value is equal to how much? 35 plus 55 divided by 2. That is your 90 divided by 2 is equal to 45. So 45 into minus 0.253, it will be minus 13.92. Okay. Then minus 0.253 into 55 plus 92 divided by 2. It will, if you add this with minus 0.253, then it will give you minus 23.28. Like this, you have to calculate for all of this. So how to get the value of your I2? I2 is equal to, suppose for the first case, 35. Calculator will be 35 plus 55. Okay. This 35 plus 55. Divided by 2. Kora? Calculate kori liwa?
Okay.
Kiyon paisa?
Okay.
Did you multiply kora? কৰি উলিবা খেলবে ঠিক আছে সো লাইক দিস ইউ হ্যাভ টু ক্যালকুলেট ওকে সিমিলারলি ইউজিং দি আই ওয়ান ভ্যালু ইউ হ্যাভ টু ক্যালকুলেট সো ইউ হ্যাভ অলরেডি ক্যালকুলেটেড দি ভ্যালু অফ ইয়োর সি ওয়ান সো উইথ দি হেল্প অফ ইয়োর সি ওয়ান ভ্যালু সিম্পলি মাল্টিপ্লাই টু আই ওয়ান ইউ উইল গেট দিস ভ্যালু অ্যান্ড ফাইনালি ইউ উইল হ্যাভ টু গেট দি ভ্যালু অফ ইয়োর সি টু ইন্টু কিউ ওয়ান সো হাউ টু গেট ইট সি টু ইন্টু কিউ ওয়ান ইজ ইকুয়াল টু সি টু ভ্যালু ইউ হ্যাভ অলরেডি ক্যালকুলেট দ্যাট ইজ ইকুয়াল টু 0.804 804 into Q1, he will get this value. Okay, so how to get the value of Q2? Simply add this three term. You will get the value of your Q2. Okay, so for the third case, you have to use the Q1 value is equal to how much? 29.94. Okay, to get the value of, so simply multiply 0.804 into 29.94, you will get this value. Just check it out. Check it. 0.804 into 29.94 24.071 okay so like this you can calculate so for this value how I am getting this value 25.49 this value I am considering it for the fourth case I am considering the value of Q2 I have got in the third step considering it as what as a Q1 value according to the procedure if you remember according to the procedure that the fourth step the outflow calculated in step 3 Okay, the outflow calculated in step 3 becomes the known initial inflow for the next time step. Okay, repeat the calculation for the entire inflow hydrograph. Well, Saba, tumar procedure to jitu disu last class tat likha ase last step to the inflow calculated in the step 3 means for after calculation after calculated step 3 calculate kore jitu add koriba tumi. Thik ase. যেটো স্টেপ থ্রি একর্ডিং টু দি প্রসিডিউর স্টেপ থ্রি দেই ইয়াৰ স্টেপ থ্রি মানে এইটো স্টেপ থ্রি বুজোৱা নাই মই ইয়াৰে দি আউটফ্লো ক্যালকুলেটেড ইন স্টেপ থ্রি বিকামস দি নন ইনিশিয়াল আউটফ্লো ফর দি নেক্সট টাইম স্টেপ ওকে নেক্সট টাইম স্টেপৰ কাৰণে এইটো টাইম স্টেপ সাপোজ ইয়াতে তুমি এটো এটা আউটফ্লো ক্যালকুলেট কৰিলা সো নেক্সট টাইম স্টেপৰ কাৰণে দিস ইজ হোৱাট ইনিশিয়াল আউটফ্লো ওকে 24.07 সো লাইক দিস ইউ হ্যাভ টু এটো একর্ডিং টু কোয়েশ্চন কিউ টু তুমি কিউ টু ভ্যালু হে আলটিমেটলি উলিয়াব লাগে কিউ টু ভ্যালু দিয়া আছে 35 আকো আমি আকো কিউ করব না লাগে আৰু কৰিব সো এ টাইম ইন্টারভেল খিনি উলিয়া লৈ আৰু এটো তুমি যদি ইচ্ছা কৰা ইয়াতে ভ্যালু তো নাই আৰু বেলেগ ভ্যালু নাই আই ভ্যালু তোমাৰ ইয়া দিয়া নাই তো তুমি উলিয়াব নোৱাৰিবা ইয়াতে কি কৰিব কৰিলে হল ঠিক আছে কিন্তু এটো প্ৰবলেম তুমি জিৰো কৰিব পাৰিবা ইচ্ছা কৰিলে So anyway, so if you have any question, you can ask me. So that is the end of your flood routing chapter. So these two methods is required. So another two methods are also there, Godrej method and Ranga Gupta method. So I have gone through your GATE syllabus. So and this numerical method will not come. I can guarantee that. Why? Because numerically you have to go through this for very complicated. Means you have to do some. Numerical analysis okay in that method and basically this method you can do it in excel properly okay excel ot bhalke koribo paiba aru so that is why I have not anyway I will give you video regarding this Godrej method and Ranga Gupta method and already your last topic that is given is your what this is given is your introduction to hydraulic routing so at the beginning starting of the class only I have showed you what is hydraulic routing and the same Penant equation the formula that is your when you are going to consider both continuity and momentum the equation I have got what was the formula we have got for ZDF for flood already I have told you that flood is a gradually varying flow so what was the equation that is equal to delta q divided by delta x plus t into delta y by delta t is equal to 0 for unsteady flow And momentum equation was what? S naught minus Sf is equal to delta E by delta x into 1 by z into delta V by d. That was the momentum equation, okay? So you already know that for distributed routing, or you can say for hydraulic routing, the discharge depends on what? Discharge is a function of your space and time. That is, both continuity and momentum equation can be used, okay? And after combining this equation for flux, এতিয়া মই কৈছিলো তোমালোকৰ চাৰ্জ আৰু ফ্লাক্স কি হয়। সো হিয়াৰ কনচিডাৰিং দিছ স্পেচিফিক এনাৰ্জি দেট ইজ ইকুৱেল টু ই ইজ ইকুৱেল টু ৱাই প্লাছ ভি স্কোৱাৰ বাই টু জি উই হেভ ডিফাইন ওৱান ইকুৱেশ্যন দেট ইজ ইকুৱেল টু হাউ মাছ এছ নট মাইনাছ এছ এফ ইজ ইকুৱেল টু ডেল্টা ৱাই বাই ডেল্টা এক্স প্লাছ ভি ইন টু ডেল্টা ভি ইন টু ডি ভি ডিভাইড বাই জি ইন টু ডেল্টা এক্স দেট ইজ এ ফৰ নন ইউনিফৰ্ম ফ্ল' এণ্ড ফৰ গেজুৱেলি ভেৰি ইউনিফৰ্ম ফ্ল' উই হেভ গট এছ নট minus SF is equal to delta Y divided by delta X plus V into DV divided by Z into delta X plus 1 by Y into del V by del V. Okay, that is for gradually varied unsteady flow. And this is the equation of same Brennan equation. Okay, that is SV equation, also SV equation. So already I have told you, so the flood routing chapter is this much you require. So in your higher degrees, those who are going to pursue your like MTech, MS, PhD like this, they will get another different types of methods, okay? Anyway, so in the next class we will discuss about the depth area duration. That is for the precipitation chapter. And if you have any question, okay, regarding any topic, you can give me, so that I can you will give me today. And do you know the syllabus for the sessional? Syllabus to compose.